One of the many reasons people buy the Dell Precision line of mobile workstations is their configurability. It is, across the line, very easy to take them apart and to get inside, change components, upgrade components as you see fit. Here we have the Dell 7730. As you can see, this has a 6-cell 97Wh battery. There are three screws and a lever here that you need to pull so that you can detach the battery, remove the backplate, and access the other components. Already in this system here, you can see that you have one area here, which is for an M.2 NVMe PCIe SSD. If you take the smaller 4-cell battery, there's actually a slot for a 2.5-inch hard drive, which you could also choose as an option. However, in my humble opinion, you're much better off going with the larger battery, and then you can install 1, 2, 3, 4 M.2 NVMe PCIe cards, which are much quieter, faster, and obviously better future proofing for the laptop. So let's get these undone and let's have a look at changing the RAM and the SSD. Once you've removed those three screws and pulled the lever back, removing the battery is pretty straightforward and just slots out like that. As you can see, couldn't be easier. Now, to remove the backplate, which will give us access to the RAM, two of the RAM, not all four slots available, and also the three extra M.2 NVMe PCIe slots, we have to remove the backplate. That's simply unscrewing this screw here and another screw just here. So let's do that right away. So there we are. As you can see, very easy to remove the back. There's simply two screws connecting it, one on either side of the 7730, and then you have the back of the laptop that you can see in all its splendor. Now, what you have here is you have the one SSD slot, as I said. As you can see, if you did choose, like I mentioned earlier, the smaller battery, the 4-cell battery, this is where the 2.5-inch 7mm hard drive would go in. You have another hard drive slot here, M.2 PVME PCIe, another one here, so we have 1, 2, 3, and the fourth one is over here. When the laptop arrived, it came with this SSD installed already. This one is one that I'll be putting in today. This is actually a M.2 SATA, so slightly slower than the 970 EVO 1TB that I have installed here. The laptop also was configured with 8 GB of RAM. The 8 GB of RAM were initially here. They have since been replaced by 2 16-GB DDR4 HyperX 2400 CL14 latency, which are very good. And then if you want to access the other two RAM slots, you need to open the front of the laptop, remove the keyboard, and put them in. But I'll be saving that for another video. What I'm going to do today, though, is I'm going to insert this hard drive into the computer. We're going to use this slot here. So to do that, I simply need to remove one screw. This screw is holding down the thermal cover for the hard drive. So we'll just remove that. It's very easy to do. That's all we have to do. And then you simply slot in the hard drive. Then once you've installed the hard drive, you need to get the screw which is holding or will hold the hard drive down into its slot, which is this one here. Simply slot that back in. It's very easy to do. It's easy when you have two eyes. That's one thing, when you lose one eye, you find the depth of field. So sometimes getting the screws back into the slot can be a little bit awkward, but it's very straightforward. Then the thermal cover goes back on top. Slot that in, screw it, then pull it back. Then you just simply reattach, of course, this screw, screw it down. And then that goes back in there. And that's pretty much all we're going to be doing today. So as you can see, it is very easy to change. Installing another hard drive takes seconds. Removing the battery, seconds as well. Removing the cover, again, simply seconds. So you have access to all these components you could replace if you wanted to. Changing the RAM, very easy, especially if you're only going for these two slots. You have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4 different M.2 PCIe NVMe slots. And the RAM in future, when Samsung does eventually launch 32 gigabyte modules, you'll be able to upgrade this laptop to 128 gigabyte of RAM, which frankly is insane. I have no idea if I'd ever use that much. So that's all we do. Then re-put the battery cover, put the cover back on, put the battery back in, and then we close up. So there we have it. That is how you would reinstall, take out, remove, change the RAM, two of the RAM modules, and four of the memory modules. And that's how simple it is. You don't need a degree. You definitely do not need a degree to be able to do that. It's very straightforward. Anybody would be able to do that. This, incidentally, is the RAM which came with the computer. I configured it with 8 gigabytes of RAM, and the machine arrived with eight gigabytes from Samsung. I'm unsure whether these are CL17 or CL19. I've been unable to verify that online. They are model number M471A1K43CB1-CTD, if anybody is interested. The reason I chose to take this out and put in my own RAM is because I felt that the RAM was better, more affordable. If I was to ever sell this machine, I'd take out the more expensive RAM and put this one back in. The same with the SSDs. At the moment, something like a Samsung 970 Evo or Pro, the best, in my opinion, SSDs on the market, you can get them at much better price than what Dell is offering on their configuration website. And with up to four slots available, you could have four M.2 PCIe NVMe cards in this machine, which, as you can imagine, the speed is incredible. Now, if you'd like to know what difference does this make compared to something like an M6600, the last video I did on this laptop was about 3 minutes. To test it, I ran that on a new machine, on this machine, and it was well over half the time it took. It took just about 6 minutes, whereas on the M6600, it took over 20 minutes to render that particular video. So it is insanely fast. This copying and pasting files around between this laptop to the other laptops is also very, very fast, because you're using the M.2 NVMe PCIe SSDs. It is silent. You can hear at the moment. The only time the fans kick in is, of course, when you're doing some hard work like rendering or something like that. But if you are looking for a laptop that is as powerful as a workstation, in fact more powerful than some workstations, then I highly recommend you take a look at the Dell Precision 7730. Thank you very much.